Hello, Spider Peeps. Well, I've got a problem. Well, another problem. Excuse the sound of the printer in the background. I'll show you what I'm printing later on in the video. So a couple of days ago, I was watching a video by Makerworld, and he designed these little bug things. They're a bit like hex bugs. These are called ScooterBots. I don't know if you've seen them, hex bugs. A little creature with a little wobbly motor in it and a battery that moves on its own. And this guy created this super simple design to make them. And I thought, I'm going to make one of them. So I made one and I just sent this little video to one of my spider nieces. And then because I made the little video, I posted it on Insta, and within about an hour it got 1,000 views. So I was like, what? Then of course I started making more of them. As you can see, I can give it up at any time. So you print out these two little pieces, download it from makerworld if you've got a Bambu lab machine, and just send it to the printer, and they take about a quarter of an hour to print out. The pieces aren't the same. The pieces are left and right hand. How do I use them? Right, okay, so we need one of these. These 2032 batteries are a bit bigger than the teeny little coin cells that the kids swallow. If you're going to make one of these, just be careful with this cell, because you don't want any child that you know ingesting these. And now we need a wobble motor, which is out of a smartphone. So I went on Amazon to find them, and he said that it was 10 mil by 3 mil width. And I was struggling finding one of them. I found a 2.7 mil one, and I found a 3.something mil one. And I was sort of like looking. Finally, I found these ones, so I ordered them. And that was my mistake. As you see, I ordered just two of them. I ordered a couple. More than a couple, really. Yeah, I ordered 50. I just thought if I was going to make something, I may as well make something. All right, now how these work, the real cool bit about it is that they go in there and the wires come through this little channel on the inside. See that little channel there? And then that's the bit that cuts the battery. And of course, because I bought these ones that are the wrong ones, I can't make them as simply as he does in his video. By the way, I'll link to his video below. Actually, this design reminds me of the design inside a LED tea light. I did a video about that here. But just the way that you can completely simplify a design. So all you have to do really is stick the wires through the holes, stick that in there and push the pieces together, and that's it. But of course, it's me that's complicated it. Spidermaf always likes a bit of complication. So I'm going to need to solder an extra bit of wire on there. All right, and I'm not sure about the width of the wire, so I've got some of my hookup wire here, and I'm going to get just a few strands, I think, and try and do it this way. I'll twirl those so it's just one piece, hopefully, before I cut it off. We've just got to make sure that we don't put too much solder on, so I'm going to be super sparing with my solder on this. This is just to hold these wires together to begin with. All right, so I'm hoping that if I push these through there, they'll pop out. Maybe that way. Yeah, all right, so that works. So if I leave that about there, and just while I'm at it, I'm just going to solder this end as well, so I can keep the other bit of the wire. Yeah, that's slightly too big to go through there anyway, isn't it? Yeah. So I'm just going to pop another little bit in the middle there. I hope that's gone on. I don't want it to melt the plastic, and cut that off. So let's pop a little bit on the end of there. Then I'll just tin these little ones on the motor as well while I'm on it. and solder one of them on. Okay, that should be all right. Okay, bit of a lump of solder on that side, but maybe it'll work. All right, so let's try and feed it through. So that should go in there. All right, now I get the other one. Let's pop those through. All right, so let's get the sticky back off this. Then doesn't really matter which one it's in. This would have been so much easier for me. So that's pulled that one out. And I've got to put this one in again. I really wish I'd bought the proper motors for these. And I'm just going to pull this wire through a little bit more. There we go. Just so that it keeps the joints out of the way. All right. So next, so let's just clip that together. And there's a hex bug. So these are fun little toys, but these are printed out in PLA, which is what I had in the printer. But I've just got hold of this new TPU from Bambu. Previously, if I wanted to print out on TPU, I've not been able to use the AMS on my Bambu because TPU is a bit softer. It's a bit more springy than other filaments, so it doesn't go through the AMS properly. But the other day I noticed that Bambu was selling this, which is an AMS compatible TPU. So I bought some of this. I bought some of it in red and some of it in black. It's pretty expensive compared to normal PLA though. I mean, it's probably three or four times. I could have bought about five boxes of filament for the two that I bought in red and black for this. Funny thing about TPU is even on the Bambu website it says it's got to be dried first. So I've got one of these Sunlu drying boxes, and actually I've got to dry it for about 12 hours or whatever, but there's settings on this. So let's get the TPU out. I've used this before, so I need to dry this again. It's why the pack's already open. So let's get that pack. So let's get this reel and put it into the Sunlu. And you see on the front of the Sunlu, you can program it with the amount of hours that you want it to be drying for and also the heat. But this one only goes up to 55 to dry it. So I'll just have to leave it for quite a few hours overnight. All right. So when that's dried, I can put it in the AMS. Do you like my Nerdforge sticker? Hansi gave me that directly into my hands. So let's pop it in there. It goes in easily, just like any other filament reel would go into it. Can just feed it into the AMS motor and it'll pull it through. All right. So I'll go back to Bambu Studio. I need to tell it to refresh the filaments. There you go. So it's going to the hex bug model and I can just select both of those. So Control A to select everything on the board and just right click on it and say change filament to TPU. All right, I'll send that to the printer and let's see what that's like. All right, so it's definitely more springy. So let's get one of these made up and shall we have a race? Okay, so I've switched to using this single coil cable now. I think this is going to be a bit more reliable and a bit easier to solder. So I'm going to get this soldered in. I'll fast forward this bit. And I should be able to fold this now and just push it together. And you can see down here the two bits of wire at either side and they should make contact with the battery. Hey look, here's a battery. So let's push it down. So as soon as I push it, don't know whether you can hear that, but as soon as I push it down it starts to buzz. So let's test this and just engage. Well, that works. Yeah, and you can push them out to the bottom, of course. Push them out that way, and then they stop. All right, so time for a race, I think. Which do you think is the best? Okay, at the top of the screen, we have trendy new red TPU ScooterBot. Prime him up. And on the bottom of the screen, we have traditional old PLA ScooterBot. Let's prime him up. Now they're under starter's orders. Ready, set, go. Yeah, I think we have a clear winner in the TPU. Okay, so this is Bambu AMS compatible TPU for the win. The reason I started playing about with the TPU is because I'd printed this little case out for my TS soldering iron. Don't know if you've seen these, but they're pretty good. They're pretty cool. You pop the soldering iron tip into it and then it works on USB power delivery. There's a pretty fine tip on that. So it's good for PCB work and trying to fix PCB stuff. Did you see the struggle I had pulling that out? So this is just PLA on this. So even though it's red, let's get these out. See, it grips onto them just slightly too tight. And it worries me that I might break these tips, which aren't the cheapest. Because you don't just replace the tip, you replace the whole sort of heater element. Right, so this is PLA, which I've got that was red. So I'm going to try and print this in my red TPU. Oh, all right, definitely not bendy. And here it is printing. All right, so it's a bit fiddly getting it out. It's very stuck to the build plate, as you can see here. I've had to fight it, but here it is. And eventually I pulled it off. I've forgot to press play. Forgot to press record. Yeah, eventually I got it off the board. But anyway, let's just take this edge bit off because it's very satisfying. Oh, so here they are. So you see straight away it's a bit more bendy, which is good, which is what we're expecting, that it's got a little bit of flex in it. Okay, so that one can go in there. Oh, did that the other way. A little bit of string in there, which if you don't dry your TPU, you have to expect that. So obviously I didn't dry this as well as I could have done. I just realized the other one's the other way around. So let's pop that in there. Fits well. And then this is the bit that holds the soldering iron. So that wasn't really gripped. I wonder if it falls. No, that doesn't really want to grip it. The special cable you get with it, the power delivery cable, that goes in a satisfying manner. Mm-hmm. Lovely. And let's see whether these goes in. I mean, I know these will go in. I think probably the biggest thing is, will they stay in? No, they won't. Denied. Oh, that one goes in. Oh, it does go in. What was I doing? Yeah, so it just clipped a bit at the bottom. But yeah, that holds them in. And they fight a lot less when I'm pulling them out, much less strain on it. All right, so that TPU is pretty good. Yeah, so it does work, but it's well expensive, so I won't be printing tons of stuff on it. So this TPU is pretty good. It's better for the hex bugs. Well, is it better? I don't know. It's probably not worth wasting TPU on printing these hex bugs out, but they're only a couple of grams, so it doesn't actually use that much of it. But I might stick to just standard PLA or silk silver PLA like this is for my hex bug obsession. All right, hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a like if you liked it. If not, just subscribe. Bye. Ah, the wire broke. Okay, I'm gonna buy some proper rumble motors. Would anyone like to buy 50? Well, 49.